Hello everyone, Roy Kerckhoffs here. Today I am going to color this little 12x8. This photo was printed with a light jet on resin-coated matte photo paper. This photo was taken in Solana Beach at Tide Park, or known as Tabletops for the surfers. What I would like to show you is that you can actually paint with Marshall photo oils opaquely. Normally the Marshall photo oils are used to colorize photos, which I'm going to do here too for most of the photo. But the sky, I would like to show you, can actually paint over it and get rid of, say, the clouds. Not that I really wanted to, and I'd like the clouds here, but just as an example. So this is titanium white, which is part of the Marshall photo oil series, and it's an opaque color. So you can actually color opaquely with all the colors when you mix these colors with titanium white. So that's what I will show you. So let's grab some of that titanium white. And the color sky blue. And then I'm going to mix these with a Q-tip. Okay, and then I'm going to paint that on using a cotton round. And you can see it's opaque. You have to put it on a little thicker too. If you do it too thin, you might still see, or you will still see, the structure underneath. Let's also create a little gradient going from top to bottom. So we'll add more white. Yeah, let's mix it first. Grab this also off the Q-tip so we don't waste that paint. And then we'll try to salvage the palm tree later. So let's remove this already here. And since it's oil, we can nicely blend these two layers. Okay, more white. I'm putting it on, brushing it on with a cotton round, and I'm kind of dabbing it on to kind of fill the spots where the sky is still coming through of the photo. So I think I need to do that with a Q-tip here. Give that detail right next to the bluffs. And blend it together around the palm tree. So I'm going back and forth between the two layers here, picking some up paint, putting it here, and vice versa. And then we'll take a very pointy Q-tip. This is called an IT. And then I can remove the paint off the palm tree. There we go. So let's continue blending these two. Thank you. Okay, let's take the clean side. And dabbing it back and forth between the two layers. I guess I could add a little more here. Okay, let's add again a little bit more white. Normally when I do that image, I actually use transparent oils and color in between the clouds, and then when I go over the clouds I remove it. I remove the paint and then make the clouds fluffy again. But this is to show you that you can actually paint over it with opaque martial oils. So let's do something a little different. I'll grab more white. But also we'll add in a little bit of carmine, which is red. I mean, the sky was more interesting with the clouds. So to offset that, I'm going to add a little bit like sunset-y colors towards the bottom here. Soon. Creating a purple. Okay, we can conclude that these Q-tips are not ideal to mix the opaque oil. Okay, clean one. And trying to blend it a little better. Okay, that's my white over here. Let's grab more white. Let's see if the back of these is better to mix the paint. Let's grab some blue, some a little more carmine. Okay, let's blend them a little bit more. I'm adding a little bit of this pink color to the previous layer I did. Okay. Carmine. More white. Some cadmium yellow. Let's see, we might need more white. Yeah, let's add a little bit more white. You can see you do need a lot of white in order to do this. blending. Okay, and now for that very last layer, let's add some more yellow. Now smooth that out a little bit and blend it with the previous layer. There. Let's clean this up a little bit here. Where I went on the bluff with opaque oils. Okay, clouds are gone. So now the rest of the image I'm going to color with regular translucent mushroom oils, mushroom photo oils. So let's add some burnt sienna to the bluffs here. And to the sand. So you can still use this one. So I'll stay away from the edges and I'll finish that with a Q-tip because now I have to be careful not to go into the opaque sky. It's a nice color contrast also between the sky and the beach and the bluffs. take a Q-tip, pick up some of that burnt sienna and finish the bluffs or cliffs, whatever they are. I guess really it's a seawall. Fortified bluff. Remove a little, yeah, the clean side still. Okay, now I'm randomly removing a little bit of color here and there, just to give it some extra contrast. And some of the darker spots here, here maybe, we'll add a little more. So, so we have a nice structure going on in this area. And in the distance, I would like to remove more of that color to enhance that, or to conserve that atmospheric perspective. And overall, I like the beach to be a little lighter. So it's still the same color we used here and here, but with different values. Okay, don't want it here. So let's remove it. And then maybe some of these reflections of highlights. And maybe in the foreground here, I like a little more. There we are. And now the last thing to do, I would like to add some Chinese blue to the ocean. Again, with a Q-tip, because we have to be careful, again, not to go over the horizon. Mostly adding the color now, I'm not too careful yet by smoothing it out. Maybe a hint here. Thank you. also the breaking waves. I would like to keep those the way they are. And now with the clean side of the Q-tip, or a clean Q-tip, I smooth this out. Remove it here. And the rest here, because I'm far away from the horizon, and I can use a cotton round to smooth this area out. And we're done. So you can see, we completely got rid of the clouds in the sky that were there earlier by covering them with opaque martial photo oils by using titanium white, mixing it with some existing martial photo oil colors. So if you like this video, please hit that like button. If you want to see more of my work, please also subscribe to my channel. And you can also see other work I've done. Actually, I'm thinking of doing this one in big on canvas with acrylics. And I will see you next time.